And welcome back to Tango Angeles. I'm Ronaldo, your host, and today is February 18th. Our last show was the first of a new series called Destination Tango. The first destination was Portland, Oregon, and from the feedback that we've received, it appears that this is going to be a very popular series. Of course, we're going to keep you updated as we travel from city to city, and we'll be making announcements about that on our social media pages. You know, we always talk about the golden age of tango, and certainly on this show, kind of a dance equivalent of Camelot, where the knights were brave and maidens were fair. That's why we listen to scratchy music, perfume ourselves, put on elegant clothes, and stuff the breast coat with a pocket square as we look forward to opening the red velvet curtains to a quaint dance hall every time we go to a milonga. In other words, we dance the nostalgia for a dreamy era gone by. And for 3 minutes at a time, we are transported to this idyllic place. Oh, I wish I had been born in Buenos Aires during the golden age, we think wistfully. We imagine taking energetic steps to D'Arienzo with Echagüe and Rodolfo Biaggi on the piano live, or linger in the lyrical embrace of Pugliese or Di Sarli on stage live right before us. What if I told you that one of the original members of King Arthur's court were still with us? Would you like to meet him? Would you like to touch his sleeves to catch a glimpse of that paradise of yesteryear? We would like you to get to know this man, the man who played with all the tango greats, the man who wrote music with Cadícamo, Manzi, Contursi, and Di Sepolo, the best of the best lyricists and poets of his time, of the Golden Age, and the man who is an embodiment of almost the entire history of tango, the man whose 97th birthday we are going to celebrate today right here on Tango Angeles. And that's none other than Maestro Mariano Mores. You might wonder, if you've never heard of this man, who is Mariano Mores? And certainly many of you know who he is or have heard of him. You might have never heard his orchestra played at milongas. Well, true enough, his orchestra is not one of the 20-some staple orchestras of the golden age that we've grown accustomed to listening when we go dancing. But did you know that he played the piano for Firpo and Canaro? Yes, he was hired to play the piano for Canaro at the ripe age of 21. You might not have heard his name, but you've heard the indelible music he wrote. For example, Uno, Grisel, and Este Tarde Gris. Musical monuments, all of them for sure. The man, Maestro Mariano Mores, has turned 97 today, February 18th, and today's show is dedicated to his legacy. Also with us at the studio this evening to help us, help me and all of us here celebrate this great man, we have in our studio today someone who performed with and in Mariano Mores's shows for more than 10 years, from 1985 to 1993, touring with him all over the world. And this is none other than Zita Gonzalez from Buenos Aires, by way of Downey. That's a southeast part of LA County. And we are delighted to have her today to share her experiences with Maestro Mores. But before we get into that, let's take a quick break. Our first song is going to be Uno, and it is written by Enrique Santos Discepolo in 1943 and performed in 1943 by actually several orchestras. This song became popular very fast. Canaro, Precedo, Troilo, Lamarque, all of them did this. And the version that we're going to play for you tonight is recorded by Juan D'Arienzo with the voice of Hector Mauré. But before we go into our first song and start this celebration, I want to make an announcement. I am very proud that we are the official radio media for the Argentine Tango USA Championships this year, to be held in San Francisco starting April 2nd. And later in the show, we'll speak with organizer Andrea Monti to talk about some rule changes in the competition and many other things. So stay tuned, and we'll be right back. Zita, welcome to Tango Angeles, and thank you very much for taking the time to be here with us.
My pleasure. Thank you for taking me.
You are a professional dancer who traveled with the Mores troupe for altogether more than 10 years in the 80s and 90s, right?
Yes, yeah. That's true.
Before we go there, please tell us about yourself, Zita. You tell us about your background and who you are.
Well, I started dancing very, very young, and I was selected. I was lucky to be selected in the Teatro Colón. It's only, in that time, only 60 kids a year. They were chosen to get into the program, and I was there for 6 years and doing ballet, and among ballet, other dances, and of course, you represent Argentina with there. They teach you Argentinian folk and tango. And I immediately, I was very young and fall in love with tango, which at the time was kind of weird because it wasn't young people dancing tango at all. Nothing, nobody. I think it was me and three other. And that's it. That was my story when I fell in love with tango. And then I started going to take classes outside the Teatro Colón. And I go straight to, I dedicate my life to tango. And I took classes with many teachers. El Pío del Abasto, Mingo Pugliese, Gloria Eduardo, Dinsel.
Those are the people who established your particular style of dancing in tango.
Yes.
We want to hear more about your experience with Maestro Mores, but just for our listeners and for the ones who don't know who he is, maybe it's important to kind of lay the foundation a little bit about Maestro Mores. Mariano Mores was born in San Telmo, and his real name, Mariano Martinez. He became a young teacher at an academy directed by Luis Rubinstein, and there he met two students, Margot and Myrna Moragues. The sisters had formed a duet, and they called themselves Las Hermanas Mores, shortened from the name Moragues. So Mariano Mores fell in love with the younger one, Myrna, and he joined them. So the team became Trio Mores, and he adopted the name Mores permanently. So now the name Mores means quite a dynasty of entertainers in Argentina. His wife Myrna, of course, was a singer, and his son Nito, who unfortunately died rather young, was also a famous singer, and so was Nito's wife. Mores's daughter Silvia is a singer-actress, and her daughter Mariana Fabiani is a model, actress, and well-known TV host. His grandson, Gabriel, is also a musician. So amazing talents all the way around. And Zita, so you also traveled with Gabriel, right?
Yes, yes. Actually, my last tour, when it also happened that I was pregnant, Gabriel was the first time that I was at the orchestra playing piano and also singing. And it was very fun. It's a very talented family, and it's incredible, incredible. Yeah.
How did you get discovered by Mariano Mores?
Yeah, it was really interesting because again, it was 25 years ago. I was really, really young, and he wanted the tango to be in the youth. He was a young people dancing tango. And it's what he wanted for his show, the comparsita, being danced by a young couple. So I went to the audition. I don't know how I find out. I don't remember. And I went to the audition, and and they go like, okay, you start rehearsing tomorrow. And I go, okay. And it was like very short time for the first tour. It was for touring, right? And was kind of overwhelming. Tried to prepare everything, passports, permits, because my parents had to give me a permit to travel myself.
Do you remember if there were a lot of people that were auditioning to?
It was a lot of people, but I think that my advantage was that I was basically ready because I have all the training from the Teatro Colón and very young. So and it's what he was looking for. And so, yeah.
Who was your partner at that time?
Angel Sasa. Yeah.
And he's still in tango?
He's still in tango, but it's more, he dedicated after more to the ballet. He's in the Ballet Argentino de la Plata, dancing there, yes.
Of course, we want to hear more, but let's take a quick break. Two songs, Sin Palabras. This was written by Enrique Santos Discepolo and performed by Biaggi with Carlos Saavedra. And then also Cuartito Azul, the lyrics by Mario Batistella. And this is performed in 1957 by the Vargas Orchestra, directed by Edelmiro Diamario. And take a listen, and we'll be right back.
Thank you. nació de ti, buscando una canción que nos uniera. Y hoy sé que es cruel, brutal quizá el castigo que te doy. Sin palabras esta música venirte, donde quiera que la escuche tu traición. La noche más absurda y más triste, cuando estás riendo, cuando lloré tu ilusión. Perdóname si es Dios quien quiso castigarte al fin. Si hay llanto que pueden perseguir así, estas notas que nacieron por tu amor, al final son un silicio que abrirá de una historia, con su silicio, con memoria. Cuanto querido mi dolor, se alzará cada vez que oigas esta canción.
Cuartito azul, dulce morada de mi vida, fiel testigo de mi tierna juventud. Llegó la hora de la triste despedida, ya lo ves, todo en el mundo es inquietud. Ya no soy más aquel muchacho oscuro, todo un señor desde esta tarde soy. Sin embargo, cuartito, te lo juro, nunca estuve tan triste como hoy. Cuartito azul de mi primera pasión, vos guardarás todo mi corazón. Si alguna vez volviera la que amé, vos le dirás que nunca lo olvidé. Cuartito azul, hoy te canto mi adiós, ya no abriré tu puerta y tu balcón. De mi primera pasión, vos guardarás todo mi corazón. Si alguna vez volviera la que amé, vos le dirás que nunca olvidé. Cuartito azul, hoy te canto mi adiós, ya no abriré. Tu puerta y tu balcón.
Welcome back to Tango Angeles. We are live this evening from Hollywood, California, and we love doing our show here at the historic Sunset Gower Studios. I have read the lyrics to Cuartito Azul as it really captures the spirit of a young man, poor but hopeful, and most of all, grateful. And of course, we've all been there. So the story goes like this. Mariano Mores was writing an arrangement for La Comparsita, but when lyricist Mario Batistella heard it, he told Mores that there was a tango in there, and it turned into Cuartito Azul, meaning blue room, or a blue quarter, a quarters, living quarter. This was a room Mariano Mores rented at 2410 Serrano Street in Palermo, and he did this to live near his girlfriend. One day he had the idea to paint it, and he dissolved blue tablets, commonly used at the time for bleaching clothes, and painted the walls with it. So Batistella wrote the lyrics about that. And I'd like to read these to you because they're quite moving and touching. Little blue room, sweet home of my life, faithful witness to my tender youth. It is time for a sad farewell. As you see, everything in the world is restless. I am no longer that unknown boy. A gentleman I am this afternoon. However, little room, I swear I have never been as sad as today. Little blue room, my first passion, you'll keep all my heart. If ever the one I loved comes back, tell her I never forgot. Little blue room, today I sing my goodbye. I no longer will open your door or your balcony. Here I lived all my burning fantasy, and I sang to love with joy. Here is where my beloved sobbed, reciting the verses of Chenier. Maybe I will boast the glory and honor as nobody reached, but nothing will be so adorable and sincere like you. Beautiful, beautiful words.
Ah, beautiful, beautiful. Yeah.
Again, those were written so long ago. So, Zita, what was Mariano Mores, what was it like to work with a man who I'm sure was quite demanding?
Very demanding, yes. Yeah. but it's an incredible experience because, again, I was very young and I finished my formation with such an artist that so picky and strict what he wanted. He was clear what he wanted, and he didn't stop until he get it on stage, right? And also powerful, and you know, he always, every single show, it was an opportunity that we were in Japan, and we did 65 shows in 90 days in 60 different cities.
Wow.
So it was crazy, and
good thing you were young.
I was young, but he wasn't.
He was probably, what, in his 70s, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, getting close to 80.
And his energy was like, sometimes you go, oh, another show? Yes, really? And just looking at him, the way he entered so powerful on the stage and started, you know, directing that orchestra, and everybody started becoming alive all of a sudden. And you know, you have that energy to get into stage and give everything. It was really incredible experience, and so professional. Every day was everything perfect, and you know, trying to give the best. So really, yeah, I learned a lot, and you know, mark the rest of my career, right? Cause,
well, and I'm sure that you also had a choice to be with him or not. I mean, to spend that much time traveling around with I mean, 10 years altogether is a big chunk out of someone's life.
Oh, yeah, yeah, because, we, again, like this tour, probably the other ones wasn't that heavy, but still we're sharing airplanes, buses, lunch, dinners, parties, everything, interviews, pictures, name it, rehearsals. Forget about rehearsals, yeah, every day, all the time. Yeah, it's you became a family in this kind of jobs.
Yeah, very close.
Yeah, you're very close.
We want to hear more about Japan and that experience. But first we'll take a music break with Tu Piel de Jasmine. And this is performed by the Francini Pontier Orchestra with the voice of Alberto Podestà. And stay tuned. I'm Ronaldo. We'll be back.
Mi culpa, borracho sin razón, perdido. Ya no tendré lo que he tenido, ya nunca, yo sé que nunca. Y en el silencio se quedó la queja amarga de tu adiós como un castigo. Estoy pagando mi culpa y sigo sin poder olvidar. Con tu piel de jazmín, me faltas tú, con tu voz, tu reír, y en la terrible tortura de mis noches, tan dramáticas y oscuras, escucho siempre tu voz, con tu piel. Piel de rosa y de jazmín. Me falta tú con tu me faltas tú, con tu voz, tu reír. Y en la terrible tortura de mis noches, tan dramáticas y oscuras, escucho siempre tu voz, toco tu piel, tu piel de rosa.
Welcome back to Tango Angeles. That was Tu Piel de Jasmine. And by the way, that was written by the lyrics by Jose Maria Contursi. So Zita, you traveled a lot with this troupe, and that's a pretty grueling schedule. 90 days, 65
shows in 60 cities.
Yeah, that's just pretty grueling.
Yeah.
What was that like? And in particular, the Japanese, I want to hear...
This show was...
Japanese people love tango.
They love it. They love it at the point that they, they have clubs and they get together just to study tango, dancing and the history. And sometimes they come and ask you, which is the violinist that in the recording in 1965 with... And you go like, oh my God, I don't know that answer. They're super, super specific and they study everything. They know everything, very respectful. And with it shows that I went to Japan twice with Maestro Mores, and the theaters were 6,000 people. I mean, that's it. Sold out every night. And every city in Tokyo was like with the posters of Maestro Mores, and by that time I used my picture too. So the whole city was with our posters. So really, really, very, very welcome there in the tango, Maestro Mores, the troupe. And of course, they're super warm, and they always.
I'm curious to know. When you traveled to Japan, you had this great successful turnout, sold out shows. Was mm-hmm. it? Do you think more because they enjoyed tango and they wanted to experience a live show, or was it more because they were already familiar with Maestro Mores and they wanted to hear his music?
I think both. Definitely. Otherwise, when we get off the airplane, they were whole press. We're waiting for us.
That's great.
Which is, you know, from Argentina to Japan is 32 hours flying. So it was really nice to have pictures and the interview, but after 32 hours in the airplane. But really also, again, a warm welcome. And yeah, he is.
Mm-hmm. Yes. And was the audience, did anybody break out in a dance while they were playing the music, or were they very... quiet and respectful? And
no, they're super respectful, and we before
nobody rushed the stage.
No, that happened in like when we went to Japan the month before, we went to Chile, and the Chilean people, they start yelling in the middle of the song and you know, clapping. So actually, when we finished the opening number in Japan, and we heard clapping, but, you know, we were like, oh, my God, they don't like it, you know. We still have 65 shows, and they don't like it. And then all the backstage crowd, they start telling us how much they like it. It's what happened is they pay respect. So they clap at the end. At the end, they stand up, stand in ovation, always. But during the show, they respect you. And so they let you perform, so they don't yell or anything. So, yeah, it's interesting how the cultures react different.
I don't know if you know, but largest collection of tango music is stored in Japan.
Oh, wow. I'm not surprised, but I didn't know.
Yeah, Akihito Baba is the gentleman's name. He's been collecting vinyl records and every possible piece of tango music. So... it's interesting that
definitely
would be. And then I've mentioned this before on the show. During World War II, Emperor Hirohito loved tango music so much that he offered to bring Juan de Arienzo and his orchestra to Japan. But they were afraid of flying as a result of the tragedy with Carlos Gardel. So he offered to send a submarine to bring them to Japan, but apparently they turned that offer down too. So that's the story.
Anyway.
I mean, this love of tango in Japan has been going, love affair, for a long time.
Yes, long time, yes.
Let's have another music break. Taquito Militar. This is the lyrics by Dante Gilardoni, and this is performed by Armando Pontiers. It's an instrumental version. It's really quite lovely, very spirited song, and this was done in 1952. And stay tuned, and we'll be back with Zita Gonzalez and Mariano Mores. And you are listening to Tango Ángeles. ¶¶ welcome back to Tango Angeles. Zita, tell us about Mariano Mores' personality. You traveled with him for nearly 10 years. And I'm assuming, I mean, you would think that a man gifted as him with the genius for the musical talent that he is, that he might be difficult. But in fact, he really wasn't.
Difficult on stage. Not difficult, but probably exigente.
Mm-hmm. Yes, he's demanding.
But also we like that, right? Because we want to bring the best. But traveling, and then he was, you know, joking with us and having fun with us. Also, Mirna was sharing all the time. They always traveling together, always. I never seen them separated. So, we always share all the stories, and we share in life. Again, we were a family all day, 24 hours a day, you know, for years. Because we were probably 9 months of a year traveling. So it's a lot of time.
How he managed the whole show, is that correct?
He directed the whole show, yes.
You have a story that I want you to share with our listeners about when you were traveling with him and you were pregnant.
Well, yeah. no, because in the last, yeah, I mentioned before the last...
During the break you were talking about.
The last trip I made with him, I signed the contract and I was rehearsing. By the time I was living here, but they called me for the show and I went to Argentina, started rehearsing. And 10 days before the show, before the trip start, I find out I was pregnant. And I go like, okay, what can I do here, right? And when I mentioned to them, to the maestro and the producer and the dance director, and they were looking at me like, you know, what are we going to do now? So, but finally we decided, you know, the doctors give me the okay that it's fine, and that's it. We did the show and everything was fine.
Just no helicopter moves.
No helicopter moves, and we dance also. We have in the show to dance in a very high tarimas.
Like scaffolding, yeah, something.
You were
kind of, you know, flying high in the scene, right?
Yeah, so it was like, basically I closed my eyes in that part of the show, and my partner was in charge of leading me because it was really, really... I feel dizzy, right, for the pregnancy. So yeah, it was really fun.
Your son was with you when you were dancing. So, mm-hmm. So does your son dance tango? Did that influence him at all?
He dances Argentinian folk. When he was like 5, he really wanted to be a gaucho. Mommy, I want to be a gaucho, mommy. So he started doing Argentinian folk, and he did it for maybe 6-7 years, and then he started with sports and concentrated in sports, and now he's a thrower at UC Berkeley.
Let's listen to more music from Mariano Mores. The first one is Grisel, and this is performed by Francisco Canaro and the voice of Eduardo Adrián in 1942. And also Cafetin de Buenos Aires. And this is recorded by the Donato Riachatti with Tania. And I have a really cool story to tell about Tania when we come back from the break. Stay tuned, and we'll be right back.
Thank you. encontré y con mis besos te aturdí, sin importarme que era buena. Tu ilusión fue de cristal, se rompió cuando partí, pues nunca, nunca más volví. Qué amarga fue tu pena, no te olvides de mí, de tu grisel. Me dijiste al besar el Cristo aquel, y hoy que vivo enloquecido, porque no te olvides, ni te acuerdas de mí, grisel, grisel. Que vivo enloquecido, porque no te olvides, ni te acuerdas de mí, Grisel,
contra el vidrio en un azul de frío que solo fue después viviendo igual al mío, como una escuela de todas las cosas. Ya de muchacho me diste entre asombros el cigarrillo, la fe en mi sueño y una esperanza de amor. ¿Cómo olvidarte en esta queja, cafetín de Buenos Aires? Si sos lo único en la vida que se pareció a mi vieja, en tu mezcla milagrosa de sabiondos y suicida, yo aprendí filosofía, dados timba y la poesía cruel de no pensar más en mí. Que alumbran mis horas, José el de la quimera, Marcial que aún cree y espera, y el flaco Abel que se nos fue pero aún me guía. Sobre tus mesas que nunca preguntan, lloré una noche el primer desengaño. Nací a las penas, bebí mis años y me entregué sin luchar. En tu mezcla milagrosa de sabiondo y suicida, yo aprendí filosofía, dados timba y la poesía cruel de no pensar más en mí.
We cannot talk about Discepolo without talking about Tania. She was born in 1883. And she lived until 1999, 106. Unbelievable, huh?
Yes, yes.
Tania is another one of those colorful characters of tango. She was born Ana Luciano Divis in Toledo, Spain, and came to Buenos Aires on a tour. And she didn't know anything about tango when she arrived. And when she was introduced to Discepolo, she had no idea who he was. To her, he was just a poor bohemian poet. They quickly became lovers, and she lived with him as a common law wife until, about 24 years. until he died in 1951 at the age of 50, much too young.
Yeah.
She, on the other hand, like I said before, lived until 1999, and people were a little unclear about her age, to which she commented, and I quote, "Why should I give my real age when, anyway, they are going to say I'm over 100 or that I came over with Columbus?" She was making plans to do a tour in Spain with Horacio Ferrer, and this was just months before her death. In fact, there is a video you can watch of her performing Piazzolla's Balada para Loco with Ferrer in 1995. She sings only the last phrase, but she still has a voice. It's beautiful. She was 102 when she did that. And by the way, we also lost Horacio Ferrer last December on the 21st. And she sang with a lot of gusto, as you will hear, and loved the same way and lived fearlessly. So tango, of course, is full of stories about passionate people and people that live their lives to the fullest. As I mentioned before, Tango Angeles is a proud official media for Argentine Tango USA Championship this year. And here's a short interview we recorded with Andrea Monti. And take a listen, and we'll be back. Welcome back to Tango Angeles. We are proud to be the official radio station for the USA Argentine Tango Championships this year, held in San Francisco, April 2nd through the 5th. And with us is Andrea Monti. What exciting news do you want to report about this year? By the way, it's April 2nd through the 5th in San Francisco, of course.
It's at the superb San Francisco Airport Mario Hotel, which is a great venue because it's 5 minutes away from the airport. It has free shuttle and a lot of parking, and the rates at the hotel are excellent. So everything happens there, as usual, and we are having 4 professional master couples from Buenos Aires. They are great, the best ones that we could get. And also the official competition, directed by Buenos Aires Festivals and Buenos Aires Tango World Cup. With 4 categories this year, we have official salon tango, stage tango, stage for groups, and seniors, salon seniors. We also have excellent 4 nights with shows. This year we have 2 master shows on Saturday and Sunday. We have 1 special dance fashion show because the official sponsor from the Tango World Cup, Mimi Pinzón and Madre Selva Shoes, are coming. They are going to be present and organizing this great show. And also we have live music with the best orchestra, Zeta Sarno y sus Sexteto Típico. And every night, of course, the social dancing till 2 a.m., which is the best, the people enjoy a lot. The new website, this is very important because the website changed. The new website is tangousachampionship.com. There is a super early there right now with 15% off. This is important. You have to register before February 26th to get the discount. Only at this website. The website, I repeat, is tangousachampionship.com. You can register for the festival, for the workshops, the milongas, the shows, or the competition, or do all. There is a full pass to do everything.
Excellent. And Andrea, I know that this year you had some rule changes.
Yes, this is very important. One of the rules that changed is the restriction, because there was a restriction for competitors. They needed to have at least 3 years residence in the United States. Now this changed to 1 year. So many other couples who couldn't compete before because they were living here for 6 months or 2 years or 2 years and a half, now they can compete if they already have 1 year residence. So this is great news because more people will be able to register and participate. Well, this is the most important. If there is someone who competes with an Argentine person, The panel has to be from the U.S. This is the only restriction, so that is fair, right? Anybody can compete. You only need to have 1 year residence in this country. The senior also change. It's going to be amateur only, because last year was the first year and we allowed, so that more couples could participate, we allow mixture of levels. But now, no. This is going to be only for amateurs. The couples have to be 60 years old. If one member of the couple is younger, it's possible as long as the other one is 60 years old or over. But the age difference, the person who is younger cannot be younger than 8 years with respect of the minimum age, which is 60 years old. So if I am 52 and I am competing with a 60-year-old man or an older man, it's okay. But if I am 45, I cannot compete at all, even though my partner is older, because we need to be fair, right? The age also affects a little the style and the dancing and the restrictions. So seniors means they cannot be professionals. They cannot compete with a professional teacher or dancer. They have to be amateurs. This is also good because then anybody can compete. And basically, the people who compete do it for fun and because they want to challenge themselves and have the experience of dancing in front of an audience and the judges. So we wanted to make it more fair, right?
Yeah, of course. Is it too late to sign up for that competition? I've been thinking about maybe signing up myself.
What? No, the registration deadline for both the festival and the competition is March 22nd, so they have time, but the sooner they register is the better. It's more convenient because by February 26th, I mean, you have 2 more weeks to register with a discount. It's 15% off, so it's very important if they register before that date. So, and the registration is only through the new website. I repeat again, it's tangousachampionship.com. If they cannot do it online, they can also register with check. They print the form, the registration form, and they can send the check to the organization. So it's quite easy, the process.
What are the prizes for the winners?
For the official category, the best prize, the first prize, of course, is the title of the USA Champions, Tango Champions. Plus, we give them a round-trip airfare to Buenos Aires and a week accommodation. They also have a special prize. They don't compete with the from top. They compete at the semifinals. They enter at the semifinals avoiding 400 couples because the Tango World Cup is huge and there are usually 500 couples or more. You have to compete against all of them. So if they are champions and they already represent the United States, they enter in the semifinal rounds, which is only 70, 80 couples they have to compete. So the advantage is great. They have other prizes, like other sponsors give them tango shoes, tango dresses, vouchers with discounts for events. There are a lot of prizes.
Not to mention the huge amount of fame and attention. I think it's important to mention the festival because so many people, of course, are not competing.
Yes.
They're coming to watch and, of course, to dance to the beautiful music in the Grand Salon.
Yes, the festival is the main event because the festival is all day long. We have four classes, 4 workshops a day. We have 3 different ballrooms with workshops at the same time, so we can have a lot of people coming. And we have 28 different workshops with tango, technique, vals, milonga, even folklore music. We have 2 workshops with chacarera and samba. After the workshops comes the competition with the people who participate, and also the attendant, the people who go to see the competition. And after 9, start the milonga till 2 a.m. with the live music, the shows, the fashion show, different performances. Also, the champion from last year are coming to perform. It's huge. It's, the event is all day long. The people have a great time. It's also a very good place to make new friends. Normally, the atmosphere is nice, friendly. Everybody has a great time. So we hope many people come and participate at the festival.
Yeah, thank you, Andrea. You do a great, great job in supporting such a great venue, and for people to compete from the United States that end up in on the stages of Buenos Aires. What a great thing to do. Thank you very much.
You're welcome. Thank you a lot.
Beautiful Waltz, and that was performed by Mariano Mores' orchestra. And, you know, his orchestras don't get played much at the milongas, and his critics say that his band orchestras are more for television and movies and not necessarily good for dancing. But, I don't know, I think some of his music is quite interesting. And I can share this quick little story with you, that when I was first introduced to Mariano Mores, my mother actually brought up his name when she learned that I was getting into tango, and she was telling me a story about her and my father when they met in Bolivia. They used to go dancing and dance to, she said, Marianito. That was who they danced mm-hmm. to. And also when they came to Buenos Aires, right before my sister was born, they were dancing to Mariano Mores in Buenos Aires also. So anyway, we're going to play some of that music tonight on our show, and I think some of the music that can definitely be danced to. And you know,
I think it's tango, it's an evolution, right? We get to the point that everything, also women, you know, 50, 60 years ago, they weren't that trained as now. All the girls that they do ballet at some point or dance, or and we use pants that give us also another possibilities of moving our legs, and we incorporate those daily movements to the dance, because it's what the dance is. It's a popular dance. It's not a technical dance like ballet. So I guess like the music is evolving, and also the way of dancing, and we add in movements, and we add in, again, possibilities. We wear in pants. So everything changed with the time, I guess.
Yeah, and who knows, maybe one day we'll get to hear a little Mariano Mores at some of the milongas and people will get introduced to something really different.
We hear him a lot because other orchestras who record their songs.
But his orchestra specifically, right?
But exactly, his orchestra.
He has obviously a very different way of arranging his own music than the other orchestras. We heard Andrea Monti talking during the interview about the senior division that they have at their. Can you and I compete at the senior division?
Why not?
I know. Except that there's one little problem, is that there is more than 8 years age difference between us. I mean that I'm 8 years old, more than 8 years older than you. But I won't tell you whether or not I came over to Columbus. Let's take another quick music break. This is called Por qué la quise tanto, Why I Loved Her So Much. The lyrics by Rodolfo Taboada. And this is performed in 1962 by Osvaldo Pugliese with Jorge Maciel. Stay tuned. We'll be back.
Remotos bandoneones despliegan en la noche sus pájaros de bruma y un coro de fantasmas que gritan en las sombras preguntan y preguntan. Preguntan por qué lloro, preguntan por qué canto, por qué no la maldigo, por qué la quise tanto, tanto. De mi vida gris, que en el calvario de mis días fue una tibia luz, que bendijo esta negra cruz, que está quieta, ausente y sangra mis labios desesperadamente. Implacables jugando con mi angustia me acosan y preguntan. Preguntan por qué en vano la espero todavía, por qué vivo soñando si alguna vez fue mía, mía. De mi vida gris, que en el calvario de mis días fue una tibia luz, que bendigo esta negra cruz, que está aquí está ausente y sangre en mis labios desesperadamente.
Okay, welcome back to Tango Angeles. Let's listen to some more tango. These are tango camperos, country songs, country tangos. And here Mores, Maestro Mores, pays homage to the folklore of the Pampas with the song Adios Pampa Mia. Adios Pampa Mia is a song that was written by Mariano Mores in Francisco Canaro in 1945 with the lyrics by Ivo Pelay. And this is performed by the orquesta Enrique Carmelo Alessio with Castillo. Castillo also, for a little trivia, starred in the film by the same name, Adios Pampa Mia, and this was filmed in 1946. Also, you'll hear Una Lágrima Tuya, another tango campero with the lyrics by Homero Manzi, and this one is performed by Eduardo Bianco, and that is an instrumental. And stay tuned, we'll be back with more with Zita.
Y el temblor de las estrellas, con el canto de tus vientos y el sollozar de mi vuelo, que me alegraron a veces y otro me hicieron llorar. Al dejarte, pampa mía, ojos y almas se me llenan con el verde de tus pastos y el temblor de las estrellas. Con el canto de tus vientos y el sollozar de mi vuelo, que me alegraron a veces y otro me hicieron llorar. Adiós, pampa mía.
Thank you.
Welcome back to Tango Angeles. Una Lágrima Tuya, the second song, the last song you just heard, this was written in 1949, and this was written 2 years before Manzi's death. He died at the age of 44, way too young and very untimely.
Sad.
And here is Mores, wrote this about Manzi's final days, and this beautiful tango malambo. By the way, malambo means a male-only native dance of Argentina done tap-style in gaucho boots. And, you know, Zita, you had a quick little story you can tell us about the gauchos. You know, they were used to running around. You tell it.
Yeah, the whole story came because in the show, Maestro Mores always adds some Argentinian folk. And in one of the shows, it was a Maestro Chúcaro, which is one of our greatest creators in folk Argentinian, the one who started using the bolos, the one who did the most beautiful pieces of histories in Argentinian folk. He choreographed for the show. It's the story of how the gaucho entered into the city. And one of the theories of the way that the compadrito used to walk is because when the gaucho entered on the city, the gaucho was used to wear, you know, a gaucho costume.
what gauchos wear.
You know, the poncho and shirt with the jacket. And the main thing was the poncho that used for everything.
Huge knife.
And the facón. So, but the poncho was his main thing, right? Because it can get warm, can protect, because they wrap their arm with the poncho in a fight.
Knife fight to protect their arms from being cut.
Exactly.
Yes.
And they also wear it as a pants. But they didn't wear shoes. They wear boots made with the leg of the horse, which basically is like walking barefoot. So then when they had to enter to the city and dress as the fashion at the moment, right, pants and jacket and shirt, they had to wear shoes. Regular shoes were basically tied for them because, the feet were kind of wide of walking almost barefoot all their lives. So, and then it was one of the theories that why they walk kind of, you know, balancing from the compadritos came from. So that's the story. That's one of the histories that we show in one of the shows with Maestro Mores, when the gaucho enter into the city, and well, in this case, goes to the brothel, and there is a beautiful playing cards, dancing, a cockfight. And during the card game, also somebody cheated, and it started a fight, and the police came, and that's the story. So it's a really interesting story, again, choreographed by Maestro Chúcaro.
So you guys did the original performance. You didn't try to change it at all?
No, yeah.
That's really great.
It's what he did. He was alive at that time. Yeah, he personally did it with us.
So let me share with you what Mariano Mores said about Homero Manzi, and I'm quoting. Manzi was a great poet, and he was a very close friend of Troilo's, and he worked with him very much. When he was already ill, I went to visit him, and he was in bed. He told me, "I almost did nothing with you, Mariano. And I'm about to die, and I won't have that satisfaction. I have no comfort." Then I began to hum for him the music I had been thinking about, a kind of a tango malambo. And he immediately started to say, "La voz triste y sentida de tu canción, una lágrima tuya. Your voice sad and heartfelt of your song, one tear of yours." So this is how a new hit was born, Una Lágrima Tuya, and that's how Homero Manzi and Mariano Mores wrote that song together. Anyway, Let's listen to another one of Mariano Mores' great songs, En Esta Tarde Gris, In This Gray Afternoon. There are many, many great versions of the song, and I happen to also like Julio Sosa's version of the song. And Zita, do you have a favorite of the song, En Esta Tarde Gris? Do you have one that you like?
If not everyone. No, the lyrics great. And the melody is so beautiful that it's, you know.
The lyrics by Contursi, José María Contursi. And this one that we're going to play is performed by Troilo and Francisco Fiorentino. I'm Ronaldo. Stay tuned. We'll be back.
Ojos al cerrar te ven igual que ayer, temblando al implorar de nuevo mi querer, y hoy es tu voz que vuelve a mí en esta tarde gris. Ven, triste me decía que en esta soledad no puede más el alma mía. Que estoy cansada de llorarte, sufrir y esperarte y hablar siempre a sola con mi corazón. Pues te quiero tanto que si no vienes hoy voy a quedar ahogada en tanto. No, no puede ser que viva así, con este amor clavado en mí, con la
maldición. Welcome back to Tango Angeles. Zita, please tell us your best and worst times during your professional dancing career. I mean, it's not over yet, but during the time that you were with Mariano Mores.
With him.
With him. What was the highlight, and what was like the worst time that you can recall?
It's hard to say, because, you know, it's always, you have the best time at daily. Every time you do a show is, you know, you have the best and the worst. Cause the best, because you did the best you can, and the worst is over, and you feel like you could do even better. So, and the experience is it's every day experience, you know, that you have the best. It's really super high to be on stage with such a powerful show, and in an orchestra behind you, you know, that, you know, you have six or seven monsters behind you, giving all that power, and it's a really, it's a super high.
It has to be very moving to be dancing to the power of that live music.
It's incredible.
It's your
incredible.
Body is all mm-hmm. electrified listening to it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. It's incredible. It's I guess it's like being high.
Yeah, nothing like it. Yeah, how do
nothing
you?
Nothing like it. No, it's super enjoyable. And
you're working on some new projects too, right?
Yes.
Tell us about what you're doing.
In a couple of weeks, on March 14, we're going to do a show with, we call it actually Tango Evolution. It's a project that started a few years ago, and we are doing it every year in Downey Theater. And we are five couples. We have live music, Argentinian folk like music. So we're going to try to explain the. It's not like the tango evolution in what anthropological way. Since you know we perform huaynos, that is the oldest songs that we can. We still have from the native people before the Europeans came. Then when the Europeans came, those music, native music, in this case we know the huaynos, mix with the European music and we have our folk. And then in the city, when the gaucho came, plus, you know, the influence of from the rest of the world in Africa, rhythms, we have the tango. So we kind of in the show try to put everything, a little bit of everything, dancing and music. And also we are going to, because Omar Ocampo and Monica Romero are coming from Argentina.
Los Ocampo.
Yeah. Which it was, we were also with Mores together by that time when the maestro Chucaro did the choreography. So this choreography was made for us, for in the gaucho, specifically for Omar Ocampo. So that transition from
they're the best.
It's they're incredible.
They're going to be at the USA Argentine Tango Championship mm-hmm. performing.
Yes. But before, I think because this show is before that.
Before that.
So
right.
They come into LA to do the show with us. So yeah, we're going to.
Give us the dates in case you know. Of course, people in LA need to go see, and anybody who might be from out of town visiting.
It's March 14, Downey Theater, in the city of Downey.
Zita, what is your favorite song by Mariano Mores?
Uy, Tanguera, definitely. Oh. Tanguera is
I'm so glad you said that. Because that's the next song that I want to play. And this song, of course, was made famous by Tango Argentino. And released. This is done by Mariano Mores. It was on the album from the Café de los Maestros, mm-hmm. released in 2005.
It's beautiful.
Beautiful. Take a listen and we'll be back. Thank you. welcome back. I have a couple more songs I want to play. These are two songs that Mariano Mores arranged. I'm playing them because I love these songs to dance to, and most people don't. And but because it is my show, I get to play them. So I personally think they're very sexy to dance to. The first one is Felicia, and this was written by Enrico Saborido, and also La Viruta, the music by Vicente Greco. Both of these are performed by Mariano Mores. Take a listen, and we'll be back.
Thank you.
Many, many people by now acknowledge Mariano Mores as genius, and someone said that melody is in his head. And I also wanted to mention that Mariano Mores and Francisco Canaro had a very, very close relationship. And Mariano Mores did say that Canaro was like a father to him. So we hope that by the time you've listened to our show this evening, that you will know a lot more in depth about who Mariano Mores is and the music that he wrote and the decades that span his entire musical life and the man that is still alive. And I hear rumors that he might actually put on another show. It's just a rumor, I don't know. We'll have to confirm that or deny it at some point. So thank you very much for tuning in today, and thanks again, Zita.
My pleasure.
For joining us here. Thank you. Really great to be here and help to, you know, expand the story a little bit more, and especially having that personal experience that you had with Maestro Mores. He is truly a musical genius. And like I said, his career encompasses almost the entire history of tango. And he's dedicated himself to spreading the rich culture of tango around the world. So everybody, send him happy birthday wishes. Don't forget to sign up for the Argentine Tango USA Championship. The website is tangousachampionship.com. That's tangousachampionship.com. And the early bird special ends on February 26th. If you want to compete, you still have some time to register until March 19th. And, well, this will give me several weeks to waver back and forth as to whether or not I'm going to join. But being the Libra that I am, I'll probably be doing a lot of that. Also, all the tango lovers heading to Valentango starting today, I'm very envious of you all. Enjoy the bliss. And please listen to our Destination Tango Portland. Our next show is on March 4th, and we're very excited to finally have Miriam Larici and Leonardo Barrionuevo with us, champions, of course, of the NBC's superstars of dance. And I can tell you, just from doing the research on this couple, the list goes on and on and on and on, all their tremendous accomplishments. La comparsita tonight, of course, is by Mariano Mores, and this was recorded in 1958. So happy birthday to the maestro. Muchos felices cumpleaños y muchos, muchos más, señor Mores. And Zita, again, thank you for being here to do this with us.
Thank you, Ronaldo. And from the bottom of my heart for the maestro, happy birthday.
Thank you. And from Hollywood, California, this is Tango Angeles, and I'm Ronaldo. Good night. Thank you.
Thank you.